حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر.
الله
لا إله إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Rich and poor, we go to bed and we wake up worrying. The poor amongst us, worrying that tomorrow we might not have enough to put food on our tables. We are worried that we may get that so-called pink slip. We're worried that whatever I have saved might be gone soon. And the rich amongst us, we worry that this might be the only quarter that's in the black, and then the next one might be in the red. We worry that there might be a bankruptcy looms at the horizon. We're worried that whatever I have amassed of this wealth, it might be gone in a blink of an eye, as we say, due to a disaster or a bad investment decision. We both worry. And it is a natural feeling, brothers and sisters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instilled such feeling in our hearts. And it doesn't matter if you have the wealth at your hands or you and I are needy to make ends meet. It is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us في سورة البقرة, that this is a test, and I will test you in your rizq, I will test you in your lives, I will test you in your health, I will test you in all of your affairs so long we live on this earth. And so, what do we as believers do then? How do we face such feelings? And they are natural and they will continuously come to us. By Allah, brothers and sisters, I guarantee you and myself that there is not a single night or a morning that we do not wake up to such worries. أولاً, as a solution, the first thing is الإيمان بأن رزقي لا يذهب لغيري. To distill these issues from our hearts and to distance us from them, we must believe wholeheartedly that my rizq that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me, my provision, I, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created me on the face of the earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guaranteed my rizq for me. And that rizq will never go to anyone else except for me. That's the iman that we should be involved in. وَمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا وَيَعْلَمُ مُسْتَقَرَّهَا وَمُسْتَوْدَعَهَا كُلٌّ فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised that there is not a single living being except that I, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I have your rizq so long you walk on this earth. And I know where it will come from. And I know as an income where it will be spent. Allah knows and Allah has guaranteed that rizq for us. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن نفسا لن تموت حتى تستوفي رزقها. ويقول صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث ابن مسعود أنه قال قال إن روح القدس نفث في روعي أن نفسا لن تموت حتى تستكمل، وفي رواية حتى تستوفي رزقها، فاتقوا الله وأجملوا في الطلب. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying that Amin al-Wahy Jibril alayhi salam came down and whispered in my ears that O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, know for an assurity that there is not a single soul that will ever perish or dies except that it gets its rizq in full. Imagine that none of us will die, brothers and sisters, unless we get our rizq in full. It's a guarantee from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that Aminul Wahi came to tell this to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A farmer who owned a big farm, one morning he noticed that there is a bird hovering on top of a hollowed palm tree. And this bird, every morning it seems like, it drops a piece of meat in the trunk of that hollow tree and flies away. And so curiosity piqued his conscience and he wanted to find out, what is this bird doing? SubhanAllah, as he inched closer to that hollow palm tree, he discovered that there is an old blind snake living at the bottom of that palm tree. Man al-Razzaq? Who brings the rizq to this old snake but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So the second thing is to dispel this issue of fear of our rizq. We must assure ourselves يَقِينًا بِأَنَّ تَقْسِيمَ الْأَرْزَاقِ لَا عِلَاقَةَ لَهُ لَا بِالْحَسَبِ وَلَا بِالنَّسَبِ وَلَا بِالْعَقْلِ وَلَا الزَّكَاءِ وَلَا بِالْوَجَاهَةِ وَلَا الْمَكَانَةِ وَلَا الطَّاعَةِ وَلَا الْعِصْيَانِ وَإِنَّمَا يُوَزِّعُ جَلَّ جَلَالُهُ رِزْقَهُ عَلَى عِبَادِهِ لِحِكْمَةٍ هُوَ يَعْلَمُهَا. We must know for an assurity that my rizq has nothing to do with my street smarts. It has nothing to do with my ability to whip out my cell phone and call some contacts and make $1 million if I wanted to, as some people may claim to do. It has nothing to do with your lineage or heights or color or your handsomeness or otherwise. It has nothing to do with your certificates that are hung on the wall. But it has everything to do with the adl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willed for you to go through school and become a teacher. Or become a doctor or become an engineer. Or yet only with a high school degree or lack of make $1 billion. Unbeknownst to you, someone knocks on your door and says, you discovered a nice invention. Let's get in business together. And all of a sudden, you are an overnight millionaire. It had nothing to do with planning. It had nothing to do with going to school. Though, brothers and sisters, yes, we go through the means. And we learn, and we get educated, and we go through all the litmus tests to make us doctors, and to make us engineers, and to make us successful businessmen and women. But that, brothers and sisters, is the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide you, to guide I to that end. And so, if we believe wholeheartedly, كما يقول الشاعر, ولو كانت الأرزاق تجري على الحجة هلكنا من جهلهن إذن البهائم ولم يجتمع شرق وقرب لقاصد ولا المجد في كف امرئ ولا الدراهم. If rizq would only come to those who are the elitist of knowledge amongst us, then the goats in the streets will die out of hunger. And there is not a single being, none of us, could combine East and West. None of us can be in two places at the same time, and none of us, as the poet says, will live forever holding the treasures of the world. Allah did not intend for us such thing. And so, we must believe that when the rizq comes to us, it has nothing to do with our ability to bring it, but it has everything to do that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought it to us. And therefore, لا يطلب الرزق إلا من الله. One should not seek rizq except from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I, as a fisherman, I seek all the means. I knit the best net there is. I'll bring the strongest pole to put my fishing rod on. And then I'll go to the ocean not knowing what type of fish will come to me. So I would raise my hands to Allah. Ya Allah, make my day successful. As a taxi driver, as a businessman or woman, as a contractor, even as an employee, every morning we wake up and we say, Ya Rabb, protect my rizq. Ya Allah, increase my rizq. Ya Rabb, put barakah in my rizq. لا يطلب الرزق إلا من الله. We should not seek rizq except from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ويعبدون من دون الله ما لا يملك لهم رزقا من السماوات والأرض شيئا ولا يستطيعون. And I would label this ayah in Surah Yunus as the boss syndrome. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the meaning of this ayah, وَيَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. Almost as if we are worshipping other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by foregoing our principles on Fridays in this country and in many other countries. We are sometimes afraid of our bosses because they have the ability to sign on that dotted line on our paycheck. And then we are willing to forego our principles and say, it's okay, I don't have to go to Fridays if you want me to stay. Though we must tell them, and you can tell sometimes, people cannot come to Friday congregational prayers. And it goes on for years on end. Simply because they cannot work up the courage and tell their boss, I need time to go and pray. Or that we are willing to engage in something that displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if this is the only rizq. Knowing that this type of rizq might not be the correct rizq for us. Islamically, ethically, and otherwise. Yet we are afraid that we will lose this income. What do you mean, brother? And then we lose hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who created that rizq to begin with. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ لَا يَمْلِكُونَ لَكُمْ رِزْقًا. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another surah, in Surah Al-Ankabut, the spider, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the meaning of this ayah. If you continue on that course, making regard to those who you think they hold your rizq, then know for an assurity that they do not hold the heavens and the earth, nor do they hold your rizq. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم.
اللهم اغفر لنا وتب علينا واغفر لنا اللهم بارك لنا اللهم اغفر لنا اللهم اغفر لنا اللهم اغفر لنا.
الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. I stand before you proclaiming kufr and disbelief in any so-called financial studio gurus that tell us that there is a financial tsunami coming your way, or that bankruptcy looms at the horizon, or that there is a financial disaster about to visit. I proclaim kufr and disbelief in them. I don't believe them. With all the statistics that they may have before them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, رِزْقُكُمْ فِي السَّمَاءِ وَمَا تُوْعَدُونَ. I have your rizq for you. And if you doubt, Allah continue with the same ayah and says, فَوَرَبِّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِنَّهُ لَحَقٌّ مِثْلَ مَا أَنَّكُمْ تَنْطِقُونَ. If you doubt that the rizq, your provision, since I created you on this face of the earth, if you doubt that the rizq is in my hands, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, look at your neighbor, look at the people around you. Do they not move? Do they not speak? Do you not hear their speeches? Do you not see their lips move? Do you not see them gesture? إِنَّهُ لَحَقٌّ. It is so true as if you see them, for it is not a figment of your imagination. And so to doubt that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has my rizq, and you wonder sometimes in the midst of a financial crisis, some people actually make it and they are never laid off. In the midst of financial surplus, mashallah, oftentimes you would wonder, how could it be that this individual was laid off? It baffles me that there are fools who come on TV and you wonder, how did they amass these billions of dollars? Amazing, isn't it, that how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give the kafir who does not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only someone who associates one with Allah, but someone who completely negates the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just to give his dunya to whomever he wants. And so, brothers and sisters, then how do we secure our rizq as Muslims? Regardless and irrespective of the times that surround us, for they change and we have no control over that. It is unknown, it is nakira. هَذَا فِي عِلْمِ الْغَيْبِ. We don't know whether tomorrow is going to be prosperous or whether next quarter is going to be disastrous. We do not know. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. But there are preset steps that we should take to secure our rizq. And not only that, also to put barakah in it. And to rely wholeheartedly on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for He is the one who owns our rizq and no one else, as we said earlier. The first step, al-istighfar wa tawbah. Wallahi, since the moment we woke up this morning and by the time we go to bed, each and every one of us will be a sinner. We cannot control it. Allah created us that way. لذا يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم خير الخطائين التوابين. The best amongst us are those who are continuously sinning but also continuously making استغفار. يقول عبد الله بن عباس, يقول عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص قال لقد عددت على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه استغفر 70 مرة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was sitting in one sitting and the companion says, I counted. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, أستغفرالله, أستغفرالله, أستغفرالله. He says, I counted 70 times. وهذا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And this is Muhammad. خير البرية, خير من وطأ الأرض. He's the best man that ever walked on the face of the earth. Yet he would continuously say, أستغفرالله. وتقول عائشة, في رواية عائشة تقول, قالت, سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه استغفر في اليوم 100 times. That one day I counted. She's his wife. She said, I counted that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, استغفر الله العظيم 100 times. A well-known scholar, Al-Hasan al-Basri, from Al-Kufa, Al-Iraq, while he was teaching his students, a man walked up to him and he says, Ya Shaykh, inni ashtaki al-qaht, fa'allimni du'a. He says that, rain is not coming and my farm is dying, teach me something, teach me some du'a. He said, say astaghfirullah. Another one came in, he says, Ya Shaykh, inni ashtaki al-faqr, qala astaghfirillah, wa dakhala akhar, faqala astaghfirillah. فسأله تلاميذا يعني his students they asked and they said يا شيخ multiple questions with one answer فقرأ قول الله تعالى من سورة نوح قال قلت استغفروا ربكم إنه كان غفارا يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويمددكم بأموال وبنين ويجعل لكم جنات ويجعل لكم أنهارا ما لكم لا ترجون لله وقارا. Read these ayat and learn how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to prosper. Allah does not want to harm us. مَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِن شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ. Why would Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to punish us? He is أرحم الأرحمين. And that's why in this Surah Nuh, verse number 11, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, سَيَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ. You want rain? I'll give you rain, say astaghfirullah. You want money? Say astaghfirullah. I'll give you money. You want children? You're a barren wife. I'll give you children. Allah taketh and He giveth according to His justice. And so the only thing is that we must continue to make istighfar lillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second step, at-tawakkul ala Allah. Brothers and sisters, I gave an example earlier. If someone comes to your home, let's say Warren Buffett or Bill Gates, وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى and to Allah belongs the highest of all examples. And these people know what business is all about. They would knock on your door and say, I discovered that you have an invention. Let's get in business together. And then he says, I have your back. Would you worry? I can assure you that none of us would worry. Why? Because we have a billionaire that's got our back. So what if it doesn't go well? He's going to underwrite it. And so we have this tawakkul on this individual. On his abilities to fix things that are broken. In his ways to bring the business successful towards us. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. If you rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is enough for you. ويقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما روى عن عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه قال والله لو أنكم توكلتم على الله حق توكله لأكلتم كما تأكل الطير تغدو خماصا وتروح بطانا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, authenticated by Al-Bukhari, narrated by عمر بن الخطاب, he says, if you rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the true reliance, you will fly in the morning like a bird. Allah will secure your rizq. The bird flies in the morning, does not have a GPS, doesn't know where the worm or the seeds or the food is. It flies out relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it doesn't come back empty stomach. It comes back filled in the stomach, extra in the throat to feed the young. But it flies in the morning relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A taxi driver leaves in the morning relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A doctor goes to his clinic or her clinic relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. An employee goes to their job relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A businessman or woman go to their tajara, to their business relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not relying on something else. So someone might say, Akhi, I've been a doctor for 20 years. Who gave you the hands to make that artful work of giving cure to people so you make extra money? Who gave you the brains to be that immaculate, well-known businessman or woman? Who gave you the ability to walk, touch, or feel, or even see or hear? Otherwise, you and I would have been a vegetable sitting at home, wouldn't we? And probably no one would be taking care of us. The whole world will feel sympathy towards us and make us look as if we are the weakest beings there are. And so relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only way, brothers and sisters. And the third aspect is, this is something that lately has plagued our community. When the father of the house dies and he leaves behind, or the mother leaves behind a treasure to be divided amongst the children or the relatives, the brother would tell his sister, "You're rich, your husband is rich, leave your inheritance for me." Or that they will concoct some sort of maneuvering and loopholes in some system and take what's not theirs. And therefore they break the relationship of the next of kin. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, and listen to this, wallahi, if you want to go to business with your own brothers and sisters at home. You want to go to business, go with your own close relatives or your father or your mother. Because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, من أحب أن يبسط له في رزقه وينسى له في أثره فليصل رحمه. If you want your life to be long and prosperous and healthy and rich and well, be close to your next of kin. Worry about them. Is my brother in need? How can I work my hardest to make sure that my brother or my sister are not in need and that they are in better situation than I? And I will bring something that inshallah in the future we might talk about it. If my wife says, how come your brother is doing this? How? And we went to visit their home. It is time for me to tell my wife, that's my brother, leave him alone and do not open this subject again. If my wife is going to divide between me and my brother and cause these issues, I have the authority to tell my wife, that's my brother, leave it alone. Why? يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن أعجل الطاعة ثوابا لصلة الرحم حتى إن أهل البيت الواحد ليكونوا فجرا فتنمو أموالهم ويكثر عددهم إذا تواصلوا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, if families are tied together, knit, in unison and united, even if they were far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will put barakah in their lives, Allah will put barakah in their money, and their money will prosper and grows, and their number will increase. And so it's extremely important, brothers and sisters, especially for the generation or the second generation that's now growing up in America. We don't have the same ties that we get to see where the immigrants who came to this country. And finally, and it's so befitting, if you're going for Hajj, please make dua for all of us. If you have gone for Hajj, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, and truly if we want to secure our rizq, to increase our money, قال ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما, تابعوا بين الحج والعمرة فإنهما ينفيان الفقر والذنوب كما ينفي الكير خبث الحديد. He says, continuously go to Hajj if you can, but if you can't, continuously go to Umrah, continuously between Hajj and Umrah, continuously visit Al-Kaaba. It will cleanse us from our sins and purifies us like fire cleanses and purifies rusted iron. Al-Arzaq biyadillah, brothers and sisters. I have said this story before, but if you have not heard it, it is time to hear it again. A young man who graduated couldn't find a job, and for a long time he couldn't find a job. So, subhanAllah, just like all of us, we come to the masjid as a last resort. And so he comes to the imam and he says, Ya Shaykh, teach me something. I have been looking for a job for a long time. So the Shaykh says, I know the one who will give you the job, and you know him too. He says, who? I went and I spared no one. I interceded with this prince. Even my papers went all the way to the upper echelons of our community. I still couldn't get a job. He says, I know him, and you know him. He says, who? The imam says, Allah. He says, who? He says, that's what I'm talking about. So he says, Ya Sheikh, teach me, what should I do? He said, get up an hour or so before Salat al-Fajr every day, or to the best of your ability. إن الله سبحانه وتعالى ينزل إلى السماء الدنيا في كل ليل. Allah comes to the first heavens in a shape and form and way that none of us can imagine. ويقول يا عبدي, He asks you and I, عبدي, do you have a need that I can fulfill for you? Do you have a dua that I will accept for you? Do you have a sin that I will forgive for you? يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث عثمان بن عفان قال حتى تطلع الشمس. He says Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala awaits us until the sun comes up. It is a magical time when we stand in tahajjud with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers and sisters. The ambient noise is completely gone. It is I and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we cry to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put one part of His rahmah in the hearts of the mother. And we all know how merciful the mother is. يقول ابن القيم قال إذا بكى أحدنا لله. When we cry to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, imagine a child cries wanting a piece of candy or toy from his mother. Wouldn't the mother just want to give it up? He says, cry to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So 6 months later, the man comes to the sheikh and he looks good. And the sheikh says, mashallah, you look good. He says, wallah ya sheikh, for 3 months I have been going, knocking on doors, but before every morning, Salat al-Fajr, I'm waking up and I'm making dua. And one of those days, I'm knocking the door in this company, the door opens, this elderly man with a beautiful smile ushers me in. He says, as I sat, he apologized that the secretary is not there today, and what can I do for you? He says, I'm looking for a job, and he takes my resume, he smiles. He goes in, and by the time he comes back, he says, wallahi, for the past 3 months, we have been looking for someone that fit the exact criteria on your resume. If you want the job is yours. Rizq is from Allah. And it is not from anyone else. Allahumma hadina fi man hadayt. Wa'afina fi man afayt. Watawallana fi man tawallayt. Wabarik lana fi ma a'tayt. Waqina wasrif anna sharra ma qadayt. اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا ويقينا صادقا وقلبا خاشعا ولسانا ذاكرا وشفاء من كل داء وبلاء. اللهم يا رب الأرزاق, اللهم بارك لنا في أرزاقنا. اللهم يا رحمن السماوات والأرض, ارحمنا رحمة واسعة من عندك. اللهم يا واحد يا أحد, يا فرد يا صمد, يا من بيدك ملكوت السماوات والأرض. اللهم يا حنان يا منان, يا ودود, يا ذا العرش المجيد, يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم إنها ساعة مباركة في هذا اليوم, اللهم فاجعلها الساعة. اللهم من كان بيننا فقيرا, اللهم من كان بيننا شقيا أو محروما, اللهم فأغدق عليه من رحماتك. اللهم من كان بيننا شقيا أو محروما, اللهم فأغدق عليه من رحماتك. اللهم من كان بيننا شقيا أو محروما, اللهم فأغدق عليه من رحماتك. اللهم من كان بيننا مريضا, اللهم فاشفهم شفاء تاما عاجلا من عندك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم, oh Allah, we have brothers and sisters and residents in Houston and the surrounding areas in the coast near Houston. Oh Allah, protect them and keep away harms from them يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم إنا نسألك الفردوس الأعلى من الجنة. اللهم احقن دماء المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم احقن دماء المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم احقن دماء المسلمين في كل مكان. هذا وما كان من توفيق فمن الله, وما كان من خطأ أو زلل أو نسيان فمني ومن الشيطان, والله ورسوله منه براء. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر, الله أكبر, الله أكبر, الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, أشهد أن محمد رسول الله, أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة, حي على الصلاة, حي على الفلاح, حي على الفلاح. قد قامت صلاة, قد قامت صلاة. الله أكبر, الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله,
لا إله إلا الله, وأن محمد رسول الله. استقيموا يرحمكم الله, سووا صفوفكم وسدوا الفرج. If our sisters or anyone has a baby and the baby cries at the time of salah, it's okay to pick up the salah. Please straighten your lines.
as you all know, and this is fundraising after this, but as you all know, there are many